In this lesson, we are going to talk about header accounts and subaccounts. So first of all, let me just talk about the organization of the chart of accounts. There are a couple different views here that you can see your chart of accounts in. Right now, I'm in the hierarchical view. There's also the flat view. So if you see your chart of accounts like this, they're still subaccounts. It's just that they have rent and occupancy, colon, which tells us it's a sub, building and repairs. When you're in this view, you cannot drag and drop as easily as in the other view. So I'm going to switch back to the other view here. The second thing to note that is that if you have, for example, sorted your chart of accounts by type or by balance or any of these other columns, sorted it here, and then you try and drag and drop something, it's going to give you a little warning. It tells you you cannot move list elements unless the list is in its original order. So what that means is that you have to resort your list. Okay? The way to do that is you go down here to Account, click on the button, and choose Resort List. It says, are you sure? Say okay. And now you're allowed to go ahead and drag and drop again. But back to my headers and subs. So here, rent and occupancy is a header account. Building and repairs are its subs. Now you can have a header, and you can have a sub, and a sub of a sub, and a sub of a sub, if you choose to. But I think that really complicates things, so I try and keep it as simple as possible. And just have headers and sub accounts. All right. Now the one thing that's most important when you're using headers and subs is you never want any transactions to be pointing to the header account. So what that means is, as on this enter bills side here, I don't want it to go to rent and occupancy because that's my header account. I only want to put expenses, in this case, to the sub accounts. Okay? So I'm going to close out of here. So now, why does that matter? When I run my profit and loss report, and I'm going to run it for all dates, and let's go down here to the rent and occupancy area. All right, you see here, I have rent and occupancy, all my sub accounts under, and then what happens if you've put some transactions to the rent and occupancy account? In QuickBooks creates this account, rent and occupancy other. As you know, I don't have a rent and occupancy other in here, but that's what it does if you put some accounts to the header account, put some transactions to the header account, excuse me. So now what you do is you just double click on that, and it gives you exactly what is going into that account. And then my option would be to go ahead and double click on each of these transactions, Cal Gas and Electric, so I can choose the sub account. That's going to go to my gas and electric account. Save and close. And then we're going to go ahead and choose the next one, Bruce's Office Machines. That must be Equipment Repairs. Save and close. And then my third one, which is, again, Cal Telephone. We're going to choose the telephone account, the sub account instead of the header. Save and close. And then go back to my report. I'm going to refresh this report. And now I don't have that rent and occupancy other anymore. Okay, so it's important to only put your transactions and your items towards the sub accounts and not the header accounts.